Hello once again. This is a What It Takes WIT, a little bit of a teach about. We do speak abouts and we do witcasts and we got thought abouts and teach abouts. A little bit of a way of giving me a little bit of a brand and some signature statements and some signature programs that I put out there. Here's something that struck me the other day. And it's part of a long-term process that I'm developing. I read an article, and it wasn't a very good article. It was called How to Be Your Own Career Coach. Well, since I've obviously been involved in helping people do some of that kind of work, I read the article, How to Be Your Own Career Coach. And they had 7 steps. By the way, the article wasn't very good. It really wasn't helpful. It was way too complicated, and I'm not so sure they got it right. But that's my opinion. However, I just thought, what might be helpful? Now, all of you, even if you're only in the course of life, those of you who are taking specific courses, many of them are courses that I am teaching, here's why you probably are doing it. First of all, is you want to improve something in your life. You know, if you knew how to do something, deal with something, learned how to enjoy something, it would improve your life. You know, your situation would be better. Some of you are simply trying to do the most important thing you can right now, and that's you learn to earn so that you can enhance your career and your well-being. And that's a primary life activity, so you're trying to learn so that you can earn. And of course, some of you are trying to learn so that perhaps you can help others, and that you can help them in certain ways, and that might not only be good for them, but it might be good for you. If you help somebody, you help yourself. I've been thinking about careers, and we're going to go through a whole lot of things, and boy, you can go through all kinds of assessments, but you probably can't be your own career coach. Maybe you can, but here's maybe a way. I love to work with plain paper cardstock. You know, it's a little bit thicker, and for some reason it gives me a feel to that. And I've discovered get away from the computer. It's really important to get yourself a nice pen. And I make my own pens, by the way, or I have my favorite Sharpies, and I love a certain paper, good quality paper, oftentimes on a cardstock. And I start to write or draw or doodle on that, and oftentimes, I've got almost a book or an insight or a speech or a talk on my postcard here. Here's what I would encourage you to do. Get 4 of these. I think I got 4 of them here. And would you label them this way? At the top of one, put the word calling. C-A-L-L-I-N-G. Calling. Now, I want you to deal with that word. We're not talking about the job you have. Do you in any way believe in the concept of calling? Perhaps you're just totally existential and just you do what you do and what it is, but do you believe that you have a calling? And if so, could you maybe put a few comments about it. What's your calling? 2nd card, okay? Could I ask you to use the word creating? C-R-E-A-T-I-N-G. Creating. Making. Now, this really struck me. I have been messaging, I have been marketing, I have been memoing, I have been managing. Boy, a lot of M words there. But I'm wondering if part of what life is all about is I should be actually creating and making things. Now, can I ask you this question? What are you creating? Not what are you doing, not what are you managing, not what are you messaging, not what are you marketing. Are you creating something? If so, what is it? And then ask yourself the question is, what else would I like to create? Think about that. Okay, the 3rd factor. This is the key one in many ways. Write the word risking. R-I-S-K-I-N-G. What risks are you presently taking? What are they? I mean, risks. Something that is important, and you don't know whether it's going to work out. And if it doesn't work out, it has some real consequences. What are you risking? Anything? If so, write it down. What do you think you might think you perhaps should think about risking? That might be helpful to you. And what if I said to you that life will never be full unless you actually do some risking? Risky behavior. Number four, the word is flourishing. Kind of a different word. Flourishing. F-L-O-U-R-I-S-H-I-N-G. Flourishing. Why don't you look that word up? What are you doing, or what in your life is flourishing? And now, what do you think that word might mean to you? If you were flourishing, what would be happening to you in your life and your business, your career and your relationships? If you'd say, I am flourishing, what does flourishing feel like? What does it look like? What would be different to be flourishing? There you go. Little ways perhaps to coach yourself. Do you have a calling? What should you be creating or making? What do you need to be risking? Or what might be worth risking? And what does flourishing look like in the experience you have now and what you think it could be? What would be flourishing in the future like? There you go. I'm Stan Houston. Perhaps knowing a little bit about that will help you figure out what it takes in your life, and you can share it with me and we can share it with others. Thank you for your time. Give it some thought. Get back to me. Until next time, bye for now.